On in previous tutorial, we talked about how we can open a file and read to a list box, rich box, and text box. In this tutorial, I am going to show you how we can write from each of those rich box or list box to a file. And for this, I need a button. I need a button and I change the text as write and the name as write button and then I double click on that button. Oh, hit something. I click on the button. I use text. Write and the name as write button and I double click on it. The first thing I am going to show you how very simple from a rich text box we can write and also change and we can write. For this, I am going to use a save file dialog. SFD equal new save dialog and if SFD of stream show dialog is equal to dialog result of echo it's going to use the function stream writer SW equal equal new stream writer of SFD dot file name. It's going when with save file dialog, if we are going to choose a file that we can write inside what is the context of a file name. We are going to write everything from a rich text box and put it inside that selected file. And now we are going to use a for loop for int I equal 0, or we are going to use here. I don't need this for rich box. I don't need this for rich box. And if it is so, we are going to only use rich box 1 dot save file sfd dot file name and rich text box textbox stream type dot plain text. Now we are going to run control F5. I'm going first to read that it appears things in text box, rich text box. Okay, now I am going to select the right and I am going to put it in text, or you can give another. Yeah, you can use a right rich and save. But before that, I am going to change here. I am going to use this line is extra. And here I am going to use also my extra line. And I am going to write. And I am going to use reach dot text and you save. Now I am going under my project and see that reach has been created and it is all. It was all and it is all those extra or something like that. But you cannot simply in list box, you cannot simply change. You can simply change in text box, but you cannot simply change in list box. For this, I am going to use another comments. And I am going to make this line as comment, and I am going to use clamps, and I am going to use my stream writer sw equal new stream writer of sfd dot file name, and it's going to overwrite the file name you have selected here. And you are going to use a for loop for int I equals 0, I less than list box 1 dot items dot count, which counts the number of lines. It doesn't count the number of text. It's item, list box item, show how many line you have it. And plus plus I, or I plus plus, you are going to use, I have put another, I use if I equal to, or I equal 6, it is the sixth line or the second line. I am going to use sw dot right line. Check if it works. I put a new line in that. Otherwise, it's going to use SW right line of list box dot one items of I. It's going to write the line number I, and after that you are going to use the yes message box dot show save successfully. And then we are going to close SW close. And after that we are going to use sfd dot dispose, which closes the save file. And here also we can use also ufd dot dispose. That closes the open file, and inside here also it's we can use sr close. Okay, now I am going to run. Keep control key and press F5 key. I am going to read first. And I am going to write. I am going to use text. You will replace it. Yes. Save successfully. And I am going to open the text. Line 2, check if it works. And line 6, also check if it works. Also, it's it has made the changes. But how we can make changes before we write, or doesn't need go to the codes and select and write this thing, we can use I am going to delete those lines. And I am going to put another button. to use before, and I am going to name it up button, and then this one I am going to use the text after and change the name as the done button, done button, and in what we are going to do, we are going to select the line in the list box and we are going to put something inside it. But because we want put a line inside the list box, it's going to happen via a text box. Then I need a text box. I need a text box here, and I am going to select, double click on before button, and I am going to use int I. Equal list box 1 dot selected index, and I am going, it's going when we have select a line, it's going to put that index, that's a number inside integer I, and then I am going to use list box one dot items dot insert I and text box one dot text. Now we are going to run, and we are going to run. We read first. We read that one, and I select this line, and I'm going to use. I put this line. And I'm going to select before. Yes. Oh, it is text. It was wrong. It is that it's going. This is text box one and this is text box two. Then I am going to remove. And it is text box two, of course. Then I am running again. And I am going to read this one, select that one, and I am going, I put this line and use before, yes, here. And I am going to select that line and use before, yes, it is work. Now, but when you want it, use it after. It is the same codes, and you are going to use I plus one, and we are going to run, and you are going to read. And select that line. This is new line. You are going to use before and after it appear. before and after. Then it is correct. When you are going to use right now, all those things has happened, and inside the text you save successfully, and open that text. Yes, this line is new and it has saved also. Okay, but sometimes we want search after a word inside our text, and for this I am going to use a search button. I am going to use it here. I am going to use another button. And I am calling it search word, and I am going to change its name search button, and I am going to double click on it, and in this I am going to use a variable index. Equals 0, and then I am going to use the list box 1 dot selected items. Selected items dot clear. If something is selected, it's going to clear, and I am going to use a loop. List i less than list box dot items dot count i++. I am going to check if listbox dot one dot items I dot to string dot to lower dot contains a line in this list box which is converted to string, and if it has uppercase it change it to lowercase, and if that line contains text box 2 dot text, dot also to lower. If it is so, then we are going to use list box dot selected set selected I and true is going to select that line and show it, and we are going to increment +++ index. Then this one needs the clamps, and I am going to move Control X here, and for loop doesn't need, but it is okay if the, it has brace, and I'm going to use here message box dot show there where plus index dot to string plus matched, and we are going to use a space matched and the label of this message box I am going to use result. Okay, that is index. Okay, everything is okay. Now I am going to run. Read. This one. And I am going to check the word that works. Search word. It has two items, but it selected only one. It is here and here, but he has found two items work, and to make it that it works, we are going here and we are going to select the list box, and we are going to under column behavior. Selection mode, I am going to make it as multi-simple that it can select all of them, and I am going to in the right side under selection mode, we are changing it to multi simple, and I am going to run again, and I'm using works. Now both of them are selected. I am going to use another this. It has find entry, one here, one here, one here, and as you see, it doesn't we cannot select only the text, because when I here I am going to use text, it doesn't appear anything, it doesn't change it. It is what is the not good with list box, but in rich box, in rich box you are going only you are going to use another thing. I am going to use I am going to make all those things as comment, and for rich box I am going to have an item equals 0, and I am going to use a while loop. While index. Less than reach text box dot text dot last index of text text box 2 dot text Then we are going to use rich text box dot find text box 2 dot text and index and reach text box 1 dot text length and reach box reach text box reach text box finds dot none. What is going to happen? It's going to find what we have we are searching, and it finds its index in reach box, and it's going to find its length, the text length, and it is finding, and we are going to use rich text box dot selection selection back selection back color. We are going to change its color to color color of yellow. When it finds that text with its index and length, it's going to change its color that it can be highlighted. What we have search, and I am going to increment index with rich box text dot index of text box 2 dot text dot not dot index index plus 1. The index is begin from 0. It means that it's beginning from the first item in the from the beginning of the rich box, and it's going to change the index with the length of that text we have we are looking after, and what is its index inside the rich box, and it is going to increment with 1. Means that it's jumping over the another word, and then we are going to increment the item And after that, we are going to use this one, and I am going to change it as item because the item is important here. And now we are going to run. We are going to read this. And I am going to write this and search. Yes, it is 3 and it is highlighted. I am going to use the works is 2 highlighted, and I am going to use the here, and it find 3, and therefore it find here inside it. And I am going to use I, and it's 18 matches, and all those eyes in the text is going to be highlighted. Now I am going to use 2 button, one for remove and one for clear. This one I am using remove, and change the name is remove button, and one for clear. Clear button. In remove, I am going to double click, and I am using int I equal list box 1 dot selected index, and I am going to use list box 1 dot items dot remove at I. It's going to remove. First we are selecting in the list box, and then we are going to remove that selected item. And we are going to run. F5. You are reading. And you are selecting remove. It's removed. It's removed. And it works. And I am going to use clear, and I am going to use the same. No, we are going to use only clear. We are going to use the copy v clear or reach textbox dot clear. Now we are going to run. We read something. Open. You are going to clear and read another file. Text. And remove something or clear and save it and clear and do another things. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial when we are going to make a table and a tree. See you on next tutorial.